Hello, everybody. Jacob from Fort Bend Children's Discovery Center here. I am in Shocks and Jolts, sponsored by the Fred and Mabel R. Parks Foundation. And I'm going to talk a little bit about circuits today and build some circuits with some circuit blocks. So first, I want to talk about the word circuit. And you can see right up here, circuit. If you look at just those first four letters, looks like the word circle, doesn't it? And that's because they actually have the same root, and there's a very good reason for that. Circuits are circles. All right, so the circuits, the electricity actually flows in a circle. It comes out of the positive side of the battery, which is usually red, through this wire into the positive side of the LEDs, and then out of the negative side of the LEDs and into the negative side of the battery, and then around in circles, because the electrons have to move in a circle. If you break that circuit, the electrons no longer have anywhere to move. There's nowhere for them to go. So even though you have the positive force of the battery still technically pushing on those electrons, there's nowhere for them to go. There will be no current going through that circuit. You have to have a complete circle for the circuit to work. So something else you might want to know about circuits is that not only are they a circle, as you can kind of see in this circuit diagram here, but they actually have electricity only flowing in one direction. This time I put the red wire into the little black node here, and I put the black wire into the little red node here. Do the LEDs turn on? They are totally off, and that's because electricity can only flow in one direction. It comes out of the positive side of your battery. The electrons get pushed through this way and then back in through the negative side of your battery. So two things, electricity flow in only one direction. So I gotta switch those up, and it flows in a circle. So if I were to unplug, I have the red one and the red one, but if I were to unplug that black one, it turns off as well. Now I'm gonna show you how switches work. So let's look at a simple kind of switch that you might be familiar with, because all it is a simple button. So a button is a type of switch. So the way that a simple switch like the button works is when you push down that button, it actually puts two pieces of conductive material together, and it closes that circuit and makes the circle complete so that the electricity has places to flow. When you let go of the button, those two pieces of conductive material are apart and the circle is broken. There's nowhere for the electrons to go. The circuit won't work. So basically the way it works is when you push that button down, it pushes one piece of conductive material onto another, and they touch and complete the circuit. And you can see now that I've pushed this one down, the circuit is complete and the lights turn on. Okay, so what I've made here is there's actually two kinds of circuit. There are parallel circuits and there are series circuits. So in a series circuit, what we have is the power coming from the battery into one of the LEDs, out of that LED into another LED, and then back into the battery. They're actually hooked up in a series. That's why it's called a series circuit. There's one after another in a series. And one of the reasons why series circuits can be a little tricky is because there's actually not quite enough power. There's not enough current going through, because the current gets cut down every time it goes through one of these LEDs. It loses a little bit of current. There's a little bit of resistance there. And there's enough resistance in all of these LEDs in a series that the power cannot quite get through the whole thing. So this series circuit actually does not work. Instead, we might want to make it a parallel circuit. So now I've made this into a parallel circuit. In a parallel circuit, I basically have two separate circuits. The battery has a positive wire coming in through this LED and then back into the battery from this LED, and then a totally separate positive wire into this LED and then back into the battery from this LED. So this is two separate circles, separate circuits. And that makes it so that the resistance does not add up and there is enough current coming from the battery, pushed out from by the power of the battery to go through all of the LEDs and light up both circuits. All right, everyone. Again, my name is Jacob from Fort Bend Children's Discovery Center. Thank you for joining us today, talking about circuits a little bit here in Shocks and Jolts, sponsored by the Fred and Mabel R. Parks Foundation. And we'll see you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.